Hello everyone, welcome to Easy Ganit. My name is Sunil Sardana and here we are discussing 200 must-do questions for SNAP. And I will be picking a topic of ratio, proportion and partnership. We are now starting with arithmetic. Already I have uploaded number system, factorial, algebraic identities and other topics, right? Permutation, combination. So videos on these topics have already been discussed, which are very, very important for SNAP point of view. So I will now be starting with arithmetic chapters. And the first topic that I'm picking in arithmetic is ratio, proportion, and partnership. Now let's have a look at the questions of ratio, proportion, and partnership. Total, we will be doing 20 questions of ratio, proportion, and partnership, which will take you through all possible type of questions, which is relevant for SNAP exam. Let's quickly have a look at these questions, guys. So here is question number one. Let's have a look at it, guys. It says that ages of husband, wife, and their child are in the ratio of 13, 11, 3. And the average age of the family of 3 is 36 years. Find the difference between the age of the husband and the wife. See, guys, this is a basic question to help you understand the basics of ratio. But level of difficulty of SNAP you will find is more or less similar to this type of question. Husband, wife, and child. The age ratio is 13, 11, and 3. Now, the question says, the average age of the family is 36 years. Now, what you are supposed to do in ratio and proportion question is just try to find out the multiplying factor with the help of the ratio. You see that? This is the average, right? Now, if average is 36, can I say the total age of the family will be 108? Now, this is the total age of the family. Just try to find out what is the total of the ratio. You see that if husband is 13 year old, wife is 11, sees children is 3, then the total you can see will be equal to 27. Now, if I make this value equal to 108, which is 4 times of 27, I'll find that husband age would be 52, wife age would be 44, and the child age would be 12. What we are supposed to find out the difference between the husband and wife age? Difference between husband and wife age, as you can see, is 8 years. You could have straight away taken the difference of the ratio as well. The difference of the ratio between husband and wife is 2. Just multiply to the multiplying factor of 4. 2 into 4, answer would be that. 4, 8 would be the answer. This is a multiplying factor, which is very, very important in ratio. Just try to find out this multiplying factor with the help of this. You can find out rest of the value by simply multiplying the ratio with this multiplying factor. So you will find the corresponding values, which will come when the total age of the family will be 108. So in this question, answer will be 8 years. Very, very simple and easy question. Now let's have a look at next question. Guys, here we have question says, if A ratio B is 2 ratio 3, B ratio C is 4 ratio 5, C ratio D is 6 ratio 7, we are supposed to combine the ratio. This type of question can also be asked in SNAP or NMAT, right? You should know how to combine the ratio. See that, guys, we have 4 ratios. I'll tell you the direct method of finding the ratios, right? Right, combining the ratios. Simply write down all these ratios in the in the vertical format, right? Make sure that if the first ratio is ending at B, then the next should be starting at B. Right now, this you can see that is ending at C, so this should be starting at C. Now, write down all the values. A ratio B is 2 ratio 3, B ratio C is 4 ratio 5, C ratio D is 6 ratio 7. Right now, what I'm supposed to do is finding out the ratio of A ratio B ratio C ratio D. What we need to do is multiply first to find out the value in front of A. What you do is simply multiply all the values in the first column, that is 2 into 4 into 6. 2 into 4 into 6 will be 48. Write it down here, right? Now, just remove the first element of the first column and replace it with 3. Now, to find out the value corresponding to B, what you do is multiply 3 with 4 and 6, right? So keep rest of the elements of the first column as same. Simply replace first column element with 3. Now 3 into 4 into 6 will be 72. Now what you do is replace the next element. Now just remove the next element. Then replace it with 5. Replace it with the element which is in front of 4. 3 into 5 into 6. This is 90. Then you multiply, remove 6 also. Then 3 into 5 into 7. That is 104. Now just try to see, do we have any common multiplying factor in all this, all the ratio? Because ratio is basically the reduced values of the numbers, right? So basically you are supposed to cancel the common factor. You see that all these values are divisible by 3. So this is 16, 24, 30, and 35. So therefore, the answer to the question is option number E, everybody. E is the correct answer to the question, right? All the 580 students of a school are divided into 3 different groups such that half the number of students in the first group, 1/3 of the number in the second group, 1/4 of the number of the students in the fourth, third group are equal. Find the number of students in each group. So total number of students we have is 585. Question says, half the number of the students, let's say 3 groups are A, B, and C. Now, as per the statement of the question, half the number of students in the first group, 1/3 of the number of students in the second group, and 1/4 the number of students in the third group are equal. Now, if there's an equality sign here, guys, so keep this in mind. If there's an equality sign, you can straight away find out the ratio of A ratio, B ratio, C by inversing these magnitude values. Inverse all these values, right? And you will find out the exact ratio of A ratio, B ratio, C. So straight away you can say A ratio, B ratio, C will be 2 ratio, 3 ratio, 4, right? Or either you use it directly or simply what you can do is you try to solve this separately. You can see that A upon B will be 2 upon 3. And then using these two, you see that B upon C would be 3 ratio 4. Now A ratio B is 2 ratio 3, B ratio C is 3 ratio 4. So A ratio B ratio C would be 2 ratio 3 ratio 4. Or always keep this in mind, if we have equality sign between these values, the ratio would be inverse of these magnitude values. Simply take the inverse of these magnitude value, you will get the ratios. 2 ratio 3 ratio 4. Total you can see is 9. Now total is given to me as 585. The total number of students are given to me as 585. Now try to see 585 is how much time multiple of 9? This is 9 into 654, 65 times. So the number of students in the group A, multiplying factor is 65. So number of students in the group A would be 130. In B, it would be 195. And in C, it will be 260. Answer to the question will be option A. So answer, this is the correct answer. Looking at question number 4, 2 cylinders are such that the ratio of the radii of their base is 3 ratio 4 and the ratio of their heights are in the ratio 4 ratio 3. Find the ratio of their volume. See that cylinder volume is pi r square h. Now there are two different cylinders for which we have the radius ratio as well as the height ratio. Now cylinder 1, let's say have the radius r1 and the cylinder 2 and height h1, and the cylinder 2 has a radius r2. And the radius h2. Now finding out the ratios in the volume, right? Volume 1 of cylinder 1, volume 2 of cylinder 1. This will be based on r1 square h1 and r2 square h2, right? The r1 ratio r2 you can see is 3 ratio 4. So see this, if r1 ratio r2 is 3 ratio 4. So r1 square would be 9, r2 square will be 16. Multiplied by height. Height is 4 here and the height here is 3. Right. So this will cancel it on 3. This will 3 into 3, 9. This will cancel it on 4. So see that final answer would be 3 ratio 4. The volume ratio would be 3 ratio 4. Right. Is it clear? Very, very simple question. Question number 5, the number of 1 rupee, 50 paisa, 25 paisa coins in a bag is in the ratio of 3 ratio 4 ratio 5. In these type of questions, make sure that you try to find out the value, right? Because in the question, it is given that the bag has total 300 rupees, right? So we have 3 type of coins, 1 rupee coin, 50 paisa coin, and 25 paisa coin. These coins are in the ratio of 3 ratio 4 ratio 5. So these are the number of coins ratio. Try to find out the volume, try to find out the value of money. So value of money ratio would be, if I have 3 coins of 1 rupees each, I'll be having total 3 rupees. 50 paisa or 4 coins each, 4 coins of 50 paisa each will give me 2 rupees. 5 coins of 25 paisa each would be giving me 5 by 4 because 4 25 paisa coin are equal to 1 rupees. Let's say that value of money will be in the ratio of 12 ratio 8 ratio 5, multiplying the whole ratio with 4 to reduce the value. To eliminate the 4 in the denominator, I am multiplying the whole ratio with 4. Now see that the total amount of money is 25. If I want this total amount of money to be equal to 300, this is 12 times, You see that I will be having 144 rupees in the pocket because of 1 rupees. My multiplying factor is 12. So simply multiply all the ratio with 12. This will become 96 and this will become 60. Now, what I'm supposed to find out is the number of 50 paisa coins. You see that because of 50 paisa coins, I have 96 rupees in the bank. Now, if I ask you to collect 96 rupees with each coin being of 50 paisa, how many coins you will need? 250 paisa coins will give me 1 rupee. So if I want to collect 96 rupees, 96 into 2, that is 192 will be the correct answer. D will be the correct answer, right? D is the correct answer. That is 192. Now moving to the question number 6. A plus B, B plus C, C plus A is 3 ratio 4 ratio 5. And A plus B plus C is equal to 18. Find the value of A into B into C. See this, guys. This is again a very simple question. Use a ratio here, guys. Just try to look for the multiplying factor. Here in this question, we have A ratio B plus B ratio C plus C ratio A. And these ratios are in the ratio of 3 ratio 4 ratio 5. Right? Now, if I add all these ratios, see that question says the total of A plus B plus C is 18. If I add all these value, 2 times of A plus B plus C is equal to 18. So we can say that this A plus B plus C is 18, sorry. So if I add all these ratios, right, 3 plus 4 plus 5 will be 12. So we get to know A plus B plus C will be equal to 6. Why I'm multiplying it 2? Because when I'm adding all these ratios, you see that A has been used for 2 times, B has also been used for 2 times, C has also been used for 2 times. So if I add this ratio values, I'll be getting A for 2 times, B for 2 times, as well as C for 2 times. So A plus B plus C will be 6. Right? But in front of 6, I have the value 18. Now you see that you can get the multiplying factor here. Now, multiplying factor is 3. So we get to know that A plus B will be 9, B plus C will be 12, and C plus A will be equal to 15. Right? So guys, just think of some values. Either you solve this equation or you can simply see that if I'm saying that A plus B plus C is 18, out of which A plus B is 9, so can I say C will be 3? If B plus C is 12, A plus B plus C is 18, so can I say A will be 6? C plus A is 18, so can I say that B will be equal to 3? Now, A multiplied by B multiplied by C would be 3 into. A plus B is 9, so C will be 9, guys, right? C will be 9, sorry. So see that A is 6, B is 3, C is 9. 18 into 9, that would be 162. That is the correct answer to the question. B is the correct answer, right? Moving on to question number 7, everybody. A start a business, this is a partnership-based question. A start a business with rupees 3,500 and after 5 months, B join A. At the end of the year, the profit is divided between A and B, the ratio of 2 ratio 3. What amount did B invest in the business? See this, guys. A start a business with 3,500 rupees, right? And B is joining the business after 5 months, right? So can I say whatever amount that B is investing, let's say B is investing X rupees. Now the investment of A is used in the business for 12 months and the investment of B in the business is used for 7 months. So this is the total amount of money you can say they have invested. 3,500 rupees used for 12 months. So this is the capital and this is the time for which the investment is used. This is the capital. This is the time for which the investment is used. So the profit sharing ratio will be the multiplication of both of these two factors. This is the profit sharing ratio. The profit is divided between A and B is in the ratio of 2 ratio 3, right? So simply you see that this ratio is given to me as 2 ratio 3. So solve this 3,500 multiplied by 12 by 7 into X. That is 2 ratio 3, right? So this is 500, this is 6, you will get X straight away, 6 into 5 into 3, right? That will be 3,500 into 12 is equal to X into 7 is will be equal to 2 by 3. 500, 6, and that's it. So this is 18 into 500. So you'll get X as 9,000. That's correct. Answer is E option. Very simple question. 8 question, ABC rent a pasture. A puts 10 oxen for 7 months. B put 12 oxen for 5 months, you put 15 oxen for 3 months for grazing. If the rent is rupees 175, find the share of C in the rent. See that? The sharing of the rent will be based on the time for which they are using the pasture, right? For which they are using this whole space. Now, they are renting this pasture. A puts 10 oxen for 7 months. So, right? 10 oxen for 7 months. That means 10 oxen for 7 months are grazing in the field, right? Right? This has to be grazing, not grazing. B would be 12 oxen for 5 months. C put 15 oxen for 3 months. So see that the rent sharing will be the amount of time for which they are using this pasture and the number of oxen. Multiplication of the oxen and the multiplication of the time for which they are using the pasture will decide what will be the individual rent sharing ratio. So this ratio is 70, ratio 60, ratio 45. 5 into 14, 5 into 12, 5 into 9. 14, 12, 9. Total you can see is this value is equal to, this value is 14, 12 is 26, 26, 9 is 35. So if the total rent is 35 rupees, A need to put in 14 rupees, B need to put in 12 rupees, and C need to put in 9 rupees. Total, you can see rent here is given to us is 175, which is 5 times of it. So A need to put in 70 rupees, B need to put in 60 rupees, C need to put in 45. In the question, we are supposed to find out the share of C. The answer would be A option. Now, here is the next question, number 9. If the ratio of two numbers is 1:2, if 8 is added to both of these two numbers, the ratio becomes 3:5. Then find the value of these numbers. This is a very straightforward question. I'll tell you the direct shortcut of this question. Keep this in mind, guys. If you have a fixed ratio given to you, for example, in this case, A ratio B is given to me as 1:2. Now, and by adding or by subtracting something, you are making another ratio, C ratio B, that is 3:5. So there are some values in the ratio 1:2. And by adding 8, I'm making a new ratio, that is 3:5. So what you do is just write it down in this format. First ratio is A ratio B. Second, we have made 3:5. And what is the value that we have added? We have added 8 to the values. Now, simply use the criss-cross method to find out the multiplying factor. As we have seen that multiplying factor is something which is very, very important in ratios question. So in this question, what I do is I'll write down the first ratio, then the second ratio, then the number which is added or subtracted on both sides. These numbers can be different also. These numbers can be same also, right? In this question, it says add 8 is added to both of these numbers. So I'll write down plus 8. Now simply use criss-cross method. What's the criss-cross method? Just do the cross multiplication. You see that 8 into 5 is 40. 8 into 3 is 24. 40 minus 24 is 60. In the same manner, you need to multiply. You need to do the criss-cross in these two ratios also. For example, in the first case, I multiply 8 with 5. Now 8 here and 5 here. In a similar manner, I should be multiplying 3 with 2. 3 into 2 is 6 minus 1 into 5 is 1. Now this straight away gives you the multiplying factor. If the value of 1 is becoming 16, I'll get the multiplying factor is 16. Then you see that this multiplying factor is 1. So straight away in the ratio 1:2 with a multiplying factor of 16, the values will be 16 and 32. This will be the correct answer. 16 and 32 is going to be the correct answer to the question. Criss-cross multiplication will give you the answer straightforwardly. Okay, let's use it here. The ratio of the present age of two brothers is 9:4. So I write down the first ratio. 10 years ago, the ratio of their ages were 13:3. Now this you see that is a 10 years ago age. So what I'm doing is I have this 9:4. I'm subtracting a value of 10 to both in both of the values, and I'm getting a new ratio that is 13:3, right? So what you are supposed to do is write down the first ratio, then the second ratio, then the values which is added or subtracted. In this case, this is an age ratio 10 years ago. So subtract 10. Now use the criss-cross multiplication factor. Make sure, write it down, right? So that you don't have any mistake. This is a present age ratio. This is 10 years ago. So simply see that what you are doing to find out a second ratio with the help of the first ratio. You're subtracting 10 in this case. Do the criss-cross. Now you see that 13 but minus 10 into 3 is minus 13. Minus 13 into minus 10 is minus 130. Now this will give you 100. Simply do the same cross multiplication here. You see that first you multiply 10 with 3. Similarly, you multiply 13 with 4 first. That is 52. Minus 9 into 3, that is 27. This is 25. That is 4 times. That's it. The moment you get the multiplying factor, you can see that I have a present age ratio as 9:4 with a multiplying factor as 4. So simply multiply it with 4. The ages will be 36 and 16. This will be the correct answer to the question, right? Let's read here also. The present age of father and his son are in the ratio of 7:2, right? So father and son, present age ratio is 7:2. The ratio of the father's age 10 years from now to the age of son's 4 years ago is 5:1. So you see that a father and son present age ratio is 7:2. And this ratio is becoming 5:1 if I add 10 to the father age, because I'm finding the father's age 10 years from now and son's 4 years ago. And if I subtract 4 from the son age, see that 10 years from now, I need to add 10 to the value. 4 years ago, I need to subtract 4 to the values, right? So I have this present age ratio, right? Right, this is a present, and this is becoming this ratio after adding 10 to this value and minus 4 to this value. Simply multiply, use the crisscross method. Right, 10 into 1 is 10, minus 5 into minus 4 is minus 20. That is equal to 30. Now 5 into 2 is 10, 10 minus 7 is 3. Simply see the multiplying factor is 10 times. So father age would be, see that the moment you find the multiplying factor, you can find out the present age of father and son both. I have the ratio as 7:2. Multiply this with a multiplying factor of 10. Answer would be 70. If we are supposed to find out the son age, it will be 20. That's it. This is the correct answer to the question, right? Now you can also cross verify it. If I take the father's age 10 years from now, it would be 80. And if I subtract 4 from the son age, it would be 16. So you see that this ratio is becoming 5:1, which is the same as this given, right? This is how you are supposed to solve all these type of questions, right? Let me take you through with one more question. My grandfather was 8 times older than me 16 years ago. Now 16 years ago, guys, right? So let's write down the age ratio, which is 16 years ago. When I say my grandfather was 8 times older than me, older, right? So if I'm saying that my age is, let's say this is my age, that is 1, or you can say this is son age 1. Now grandfather is 8 times older. It's not 8 times the son age. It is 8 times older. That means it is 8 years more than the son age. So grandfather age would be 9, right? So grandfather and son age is in the ratio of 9:1. Grandfather and the son age is in the ratio 9:1. Because it says that it's 9 years older, right? Eight times older. So 8 years older, right? He would be 3 times of my age 8 years from now. He would be 3 times of my age, 3 times of my age 8 years from now. Now 16 years ago, right? Now from now, right? 8 years, he would be 3 times of my age 8 years from now. Okay. So guys, if I'm talking in the present, I'm talking about this age as 16 years ago. And now I'm saying this is from 8 years from now. 8 years ago from now. This is 8 years ago from now. And this is 8 years from now. So see that the new age, the new ratio is becoming, he would be 3 times of my age. 3 times of my age, not 3 years older. It says 3 times of my age, right? So the ratio is 3:1. Now you see that 16 years ago from now and 8 years from now, the gap is of 24 years. That means I have added 24 to this value, added 24 to this value. Now do the crisscross multiplication, right? You see that 24 into 3, 72 minus 24. This is 48. Now you see that I'm first writing out 72, which is a multiplication of 3 and 24. Similarly, you here also first write down 9 into 1 minus 3 into 1. That is 6. Multiplying factor is 8. Use this multiplying factor. That means 16 years ago, the grandfather age would be 9 into 8, that is 72. And the son age would be 8. Because why 8? Because this multiplying factor we have found is 8. Now, this is 16 years ago. We are supposed to find out 10 years ago, what was the ratio of my age to that of my grandfather. Now, this is 16 years ago. If I want to find out the age ratio 10 years ago, in that case, from 16 years ago to 10 years ago, right, you have a gap of 6 years. So simply add 6 to these, both of these two. This will be 78, this will be 48. Ratio, you can see, would be 39:7, and that is the correct answer to the question. So guys, these are the questions of ratios that I have discussed with you. I have covered 12 questions. In the next session, right, we will be discussing proportion, okay, and some more questions of partnership. Thank you so much for watching the video. And please subscribe to the channel. You will get a lot of videos relevant for you. Snap. I'm going to cover each and every topic of ratio and proportion, every topic of quant to help you with, you know, doing all relevant questions for Snap, right? So till now, we have covered more than 80 questions in this whole series. Thank you so much for watching the video. Please share with all of your friends, right? So that I get an encouragement to upload some more videos to complete this series before your Snap exam. Thanks a lot. See you then in the next session, everybody.